I grew up slowly beside the tides and marshes of a Carolina sea island. We lived in a small white house, won by my great-great-grandfather, Winston Shadrach Wingle, in a horseshoe game. There are families who live out their entire lives without a single thing of interest happening to them.
Don't run so fast, Tom.
I've always envied those families.
Luke, why you don't torment that dog?
It's my dog. It's my dog.
Tom, you're going to step on him. He's only a pup.
Here, Jim. Come here, Jim. Mom, did you see me run?
Lana, you want a bean?
Here, Jim.
Boy, you want a bean?
The child of a beautiful woman. I was also a shrimper's son in love with the shape of boats.
He's pushing me.
Not pushy,
but pushing.
As a small boy, I loved to navigate my father's shrimp boat between the sandbars. I suppose Henry Wingle would have made a pretty good father. He hadn't been such a violent man. From my mother, I inherited a love of language and an appreciation of nature. She could turn a walk around the island into a voyage of purest discovery. As a child, I thought she was the most extraordinary woman on earth. I wasn't the first son to be wrong about his mother. Brother, sister, and I needed to escape. We developed a ritual. We found a silent, soothing world where there was no pain. A world without mothers or fathers. We would make a circle bound by flesh and blood and water. And only when we felt our lungs betray us would we rise toward the light. And the fear of what lay in wait for us above the surface. All this was a long time ago, before I chose not to have a memory.
Mr. Bragg, will you sell a dope to my girls again?
Stop bugging us, Dad.